Sometimes that comes from suffering. So some people find their love for spirituality when they suffer. Because of the brain waves, we absorb more.
Okay.
So that's a powerful time to do it. But otherwise, anytime. And meditation, unfortunately, is never really easy. So it does get a lot easier. But at the beginning, it is hard work. And it you know, you have to really have a lot of kind of darf to meet Waiguru or to have devotion and to really know why you're doing it and to and sometimes that comes from suffering. So some people find their love for spirituality when they suffer, because it's like, you know, you can we can all get to a point in our lives, because we all have a mind, that we find ourselves in such a difficult, dark place where we are bombarded with very difficult thoughts, negative thoughts, even suicidal thoughts.
Yeah.
And, you know, I sometimes feel like, you know, when somebody, we talk about mental health and we talk about mental health problems and disorders, I actually feel that these, when people go through experiences like this and they get to such a point in their life, you know, almost on the other side of that door, we could see like potential for spiritual awakening. You know, people talk about the overlap between mental health and awakening and like, you know, existential crises and finding your purpose and stuff. So I feel like, you know, when we are in that deep dark place, we look for something, don't we? Because what we are used to doing is attaching ourselves to the world, to the people in the world, to our things, our possessions, to our house. But Guru Sahib tells us, Sagal Srishta Goraja Dukhya, Harka Naam Jabuthu Sukhya. Or one of the ones that really hit me, when I was a teenager and I was really struggling with low mood and my identity, I was the only Sikh girl, and I wore a patka in a school where everybody was kind of white. And I really struggled with my identity, and I wanted to do everything they were doing. And I really wanted to just belong, because teenagers want to belong, right? And but I was in real conflict. And I felt very low at that point. And I remember, because I was blessed to have parents who connected with Gurbani themselves. And as we got older, started to talk to us about Gurbani and encouraged us to look at translations and things. And there was a dukh that really stood out to me. Mitar kanere kar thaki mera dukh kate koi. Like, I've spent like my whole life looking for friends, hoping that somebody will relieve my pain. Because that's what I was doing. I was looking for the company and to feel belonging. But no matter how much I had that, I couldn't. I still didn't feel peace. I still didn't feel whole. And that was where my search, my discovery started. You know, I was at a turning point in my life. I was like, do I just follow my friends and experience some pleasure and feel good and like feel connected, belonging? Or do I know that even if I do that, I'll still feel a little bit empty?
Anji.
And do I search for something more? So I did look at other religions as well. I really connected with Buddhism. And Sikhi was something I'd been brought up with. And I rejected that initially because I wanted to rebel against it.
Anji.
But as I started reading Gurbani, I was like, hang on a minute. Like, this isn't just about how you look or having to, like, you know, do certain rituals. This is like about finding peace and happiness and truth. And that's when I started going on the path of Sikhi and psychology. That's where my interest for psychology came as well.
Okay.
Because I was, a lot of my friends at that time came from broken homes and were struggling with depression themselves and even getting into drugs and bad, unhealthy relationships. And I was like, why are we struggling in this world? Like, why do people have challenges, and how do we overcome those challenges? And is there more to this world than just what I see here? Because otherwise, this is, you know, when somebody's very down and at the point where they're like, I've had enough of this world, there's got to be more. I'm not getting satisfaction or happiness. You could either label them as a mental health patient, or you could actually say, you're right. You know, there's truth in this.
And
this is the beginning of your discovery and your journey towards looking beyond.
And just if we look at Gurbani, even we talk about dukkha and stuff, it's about channeling that energy in the right way. Just pankti that comes to my mind is that diva mere ekanam dukh vich paya tel. That, you know, the diva, even someone said this to me recently, even when it comes to spirituality, that you have this fire inside you and you need to keep the fire going of God's name, of spirituality, Simran. And it's that duk that is the tel, the pain is the oil. And all that oil is used to light that fire. But they say, oho chanan, oho sokya. So basically that light that is being fueled by the tel, by the oil, it's burning out all the duk anyway, right? So what you need the duk to do the Naam Simran, but when you do the Naam Simran, all that duk has been burnt away anyway. Chuke jamsyo mail, and then we escape from death basically, or that death that we're all afraid of, right? But it's just the death of the ego, right? And that fear that we all have inside us as well. So that's really interesting when we talk about pain and stuff, because a lot of people go through it, and I guess in those times of struggles, those are the times that we grow the most, right?
If you enjoyed this video, be sure to check out the full podcast on our second channel, BOS TV.
And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Let's get it to 10K subs.